Police Constable Ivan Wawire was today produced before Buganda Road Grade 1 Magistrate Sienna Owomugisha following his arrest over the murder of Ewan Utam Bandari, an Indian national at Raja Chambers along Parliamentary Avenue. Wawire was in the magistrate's chambers for several hours, where it is believed he voluntarily narrated his involvement in Utam's murder. At around 3 p.m., Wawire came out of the magistrate's chambers. He was immediately whisked away in a waiting police van. An extrajudicial statement refers to an utterance made out of court, which can either be written or oral. It may be a confession, an admission, or any other statement regarding the involvement of a suspect in a given crime. It is made only in the presence of a magistrate and must be voluntary and in a language best understood by the suspect. Ivan Wawire shot and killed an Indian moneylender at Raja Chambers. He later abandoned the gun at CPS in Kampala before fleeing to Busia, where he was arrested on Saturday night.
So he managed to escape to his village at Walira, that is in Bumango Parish in Busia district. And our flying squad teams with KMP and the DPC Busia managed to intercept him while trying to cross into Kenya.
In the aftermath of a brutal shooting, Kampala Metropolitan Police spokesperson Patrick Onyango disclosed that Wawire had a history of mental illness that saw him admitted at Butabika Mental Hospital 6 years ago. These reports caused a public uproar as members of the public questioned the police for deploying a madman. Many accused the police of being sluggish by allowing such a person to come close to a gun.
Of the police on how they've been handling these police officers, but also the army in terms of recruitment process, whom do they recruit? Do they have the background of those people? Do they know where they come from? Do they know what they...
Great Evo, it is so sad. Condolences to Ugandans, condolences to the family of the Asian who has been gunned down by police officer. This call is for serious interest by the police leadership and the armed forces in general to begin improvising and strengthening other sources.
However, police spokesperson Fred Enanga has today dismissed this claim, saying Wawire was mentally okay at the time of a shooting. According to a report by the police surgeon, Wawire was in his rightful conscience at the time of the murder.
At the time of arrest, this is a suspect who was in very good shape and he was very sound. We transferred him to KMP headquarters.
Enanga further reveals that even after arrest, Wawire never felt remorseful and openly confessed that he killed the moneylender simply because he had cheated him.
He did not appear remorseful at all, not even saying sorry for what he did. And he admitted to having murdered the victim for allegedly cheating him.
Meanwhile, police have dismissed the officer whose gun was used by PC Ivan Wawire in the murder of the moneylender. According to police spokesperson Fred Enanga, Constable Stephen Mulombo was on Friday afternoon arrested after investigations found out that he had abandoned his gun in his room from where Ivan Wawire picked it. After dismissal, Mulombo will also face prosecution on charges related to neglect of duty.
As a result, he has also been charged in the disciplinary court with discreditable conduct and dismissed from the force this morning. So he's now a civilian and is going to be taken to the criminal court for negligence of duties as a civilian.
Over the weekend, President Museveni released a statement where he asked several questions that he said police need to answer in regards to the incident at Parliamentary Avenue. According to the president, more questions still need to be answered on why local security allowed an armed person to enter into a building that housed the money lending business without disarming him at the entrance. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.